How are you guys? I hope we are doing well and keep the spirits up. Let's try to create this 3D modeling wall classic lamp using SketchUp. Okay, I already downloaded from Google the image reference like this. You can search classic wall lamp. Let's start from beginning. We delete all of these images, pick file and import, and choose the file that we have downloaded. It can be PNG or JPEG, and use image as image, then import, then click twice. Using rotate, the shortcut is Q, snap to this endpoint, right arrow to lock the red axis, click, then click again and move it up, snap to the 90 degrees, then click. Okay, so using line, find the midpoint, click, move it down along the blue axis, then click, then we escape, we scroll, we see we will adjust this image to be center. Right click on this image and explode. Delete the right side like this. Right click and texture position. Click on this yellow. Drag to the left like this. We skew the image. Release, then move it to the right. We adjust the top here and the bottom is to be center. Yeah, it has not to be perfect, but close enough. Okay, right click and done. Okay, let's stressing this image using 2-point arc. Click this one and click. I think using X-ray, yeah, it's better. It's more clearly. Click this endpoint and click twice. We're tracing again. Be careful because it's been error. Escape. We repeat again. Click this tangent. See. Okay. Missing line. For the line, we can see from this bottom. Press Alt to toggle linear inference. This is all on. Make it all off by pressing Alt, all off, Alt again is parallel, find the all off. Okay, it make our easier to make the tracing while it all off. It's okay not to be perfect, but we try to closely enough with the image reference. Oops. Okay. Using line, we cut from here. Using the red axis is okay. We delete. Line again, click and click. We delete the unused line. So we have these three faces, right click, make group, also this one, make group, and the third one, make group. And then we create circle, snap to this endpoint, and we make a circle along the blue axis. The size is doesn't matter. Click this face and follow me. Right click on this button, edit group, then click this face. It will become like this. Spacebar, click outside. Click again this face and follow me. And then right click, edit group, click the face. Spacebar, click outside. Now we change the circle into the rectangle using R, control to make it to go select center, snap to this endpoint, click and slide, make it square like this. Okay. Select this face, then follow me again, right click on this group, edit group, then click. Spacebar, click outside. Okay, so now we have this model. Click twice. We can right click, hide. So only this face. We change the material using metal. I think we have to go inside to the group. Click twice. Click three times, then pick this one, then click. And we have to reverse because it's still left the material with the previous material. So use the same thing with the others. Okay. We select all, right click, and make it soften. Yeah. Then click two times on this center. Make offset. Offset this one. Click on edge, then slide. Yeah. Then click again. Escape. Click two times. We repeat like that. Then push pull. Click, we push. Escape. Hover to this face. Click twice. Then we change again the into glass and mirrors. I pick this one, translucent glass gray, then click the glass. I think the back side we need to reverse again, reverse faces, then click. Okay, then we can paint bucket again. The shortcut is B. Press Alt, then pick this material so it will become aluminum. Then press Edit. I will make it darker. Yes, like that. Okay, so we create the handles now. Sorry, I unhide. You can choose from here, unhide all. The shortcut is Ctrl Alt E. We need to group. Click twice, right click, make group for the reference image, and move along the green axis. Then we explode again. Using line, we close endpoint to this endpoint. and click twice, Control Shift, we unselect, drag like this, so only left the blue lines, then delete. Click this edge, move tool, we slide along the red axis, then click. So now we need to draw this handle using line, click, press Alt, click again, retracing, we can click, yeah, then we can using 2-point arc. Like this, we erase the lines also for the bottom. Okay, push pull, we pull like that, and then click scale, click control. Like that. Okay, click 2 times. No, no. You select only like this from left to the right. Then using flip, click and drag the bottom, sorry, the green and release. It will make flip. And then press Ctrl to copy, then spacebar. Okay, so we have these two model. Select like that, then make group. Pick this rectangle. I will drag like this. Then we trace. Using X-ray again, okay, you can erase the unused faces, we can make group, then go inside. I think we need to make proportion like this, yeah, and then we flip again, we copy flip, now we drag this red and snap to here on edge, release, control, spacebar, click outside, go inside the group, we erase this line, the center of the lines, then we click the face, we pull like this, then click again, scale by pressing S, control, yeah, like that. We change the material using the aluminium also for this one. We move along the this is also have an issue. If it's hard to move along the green, click this object, right click, we need to unglue. Also we check this one, right click, unglue. So now we can move normally. Okay, we set along the, you see the X-ray, click, I think it already center, and then we rotate this one, Oops, only one. I think it's glue also. Oh yes, I click. No, why it become, oh, this one unglue. Yeah, so you can release. Yes, you can release the object. Up arrow to make it, yeah, 90. Move tool, click on the red axis, shift to lock, and snap to here. Okay, I think it's too close. We need to move a little bit around here. Then we click twice, select only this side, move tool, click this edge, and move it around the red axis. Shift to lock and click. Okay. Yeah, just a little bit. Go inside. Yes. Okay, I hope this tutorial is useful and see you on the next tutorial. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye-bye.